people in the room right now. So a formal welcome. Sawadee ka, sawadee all guests. Good morning. Thank you for joining us today at the first TBEX Asia. We hope you enjoyed your time at the opening party last night. And we would like to thank our hosts from the Tourism Authority of Thailand, TSEB, and Bangkok Metropolitan Authority for their hospitality. And just a reminder to all of our guests, there is no time to log into your Blogger Bridge account to make appointments for this afternoon's speed networking session. And if you need any assistance, please stop by our registration desk, which is down by the foyer. And this afternoon's session of speed networking will begin at 3:40 p.m. And please join us for lunch at 12:30 in the Plenary Hall 2 and 3. And now let's begin, and I would like to introduce Mr. Ivo Terra, and he will be speaking on the content of Dare to be Different, or How Not to Travel Blog Like Everyone Else. Please welcome him. Thank you.
I'm doing this because there's no way I can stand behind this lectern the entire time. Good morning, everyone. Let's do a little bit of expectation and level setting first. If you have this question in mind, congratulations, you're in the right session. If you're wondering about this, again, you are in the right place, and I appreciate the trust you put in me to answer these questions. But so that no one is disappointed, as brilliant as I am, he said, tongue firmly in cheek, I am not here to tell you how to make money travel blogging. I will not be covering that topic. There's a lot of conversations happening this week, or at least next 2 days, about how to make money travel blogging. Again, level setting expectations, you will not hear that from me today. Nor am I here how to tell you to become really, really popular. Right now, there's a statistics and numbers that matter talk that Skyscanner is putting on. They'll probably be covering that. I'm not here to tell you what the cool kids want, although if you want to talk about Periscope, let's get together later. And I'm not even here to tell you what kind of content you should or should not be producing. No matter what you might have read on my drunken Facebook rants. That's not what I'm here to do for. Really, all I can do is the thing that I have done for 15 years working with companies and organizations. And that is trying to help them figure out what strengths they have and parlay those into the digital world. That's what you're getting yourselves into. That, at least that's what I did as a career before I took off at the first of this year with my lovely wife Sheila, and we've been traveling around ever since. So I'm a travel blogger just like you. Good morning, my name is Ivo. Thank you very much for joining me on this session today. I'm honored you've chosen me to help kick off this TBEX session, and I promise to make it fun, interesting, and engaging. At least I hope so. That's my goal as we go through. Bear with me as I get used to this new system over here. I'm a Mac guy. So in this session specifically, I'm going to help you uncover and understand what strengths you already have. It's easy to figure out what you should be blogging about when you know what kind of blogger you can be based on your own individual strengths. And that's whether you're just starting out, which I'm sure some of you are, or whether you're trying to make a change and do something completely different about your blog because you're just not happy with it. Those are the two primary audiences I'm talking to today. Because chasing trends sucks. It's hard, exhausting work. At best, it leaves you terribly disappointed when that trend fails to meet up with your own overhyped expectations. And at worst, you waste a pile of money on something. Anybody buy a Google Glass? Anybody? Want to volunteer who spent $1,500 on something? Nah, I didn't think you'd offer that. And you waste your time and money when you're not focused on the things you do best. So we're going to talk about the things you do best to make you into a unique travel blogger. Because as successful as these people are, Dave, Deb, Nomad, Matt, Gary, and Arnold, right there. Chris Christensen, is Chris in here? No? Okay, good. We'll just talk about Gary. These guys are awesome, but here's the secret. You're not them. You can try your best to copy the tactics that they talk about and that they espouse, and that might be successful for you. But again, you are not them. You have your own sets of strengths. They have their sets of strengths. In fact, their own strengths are what they do. All four of these people travel blog, in air quotes, incredibly different from one another. But they do the things that they are good at. And that's what's important, knowing what it is you're good at. Because different's better. And we need a wide and rich sea of travel content producers out there. Let me give you some examples. These guys. Stefan and Sebastian, are you in here?
Yeah.
So these guys, they use humor and on-brand photography almost always of themselves to tell engaging, compelling stories about where they are in the world. They don't worry about things like what's the proper word count for an article. They don't care about that stuff. They're just telling engaging stories, and they completely embrace their niche, gay travel. Really, really gay travel. But they own it, man. Why should they not? Why should they not, right? So then we have these guys. This is Jurgen and Mike. I don't think they're here at the conference, but they're on a blog called 491 Days. F-O-R, 491 Days. So these guys approach travel blogging not as travel professionals, like many of us consider ourselves, and not even tourists. They tell their stories of different destinations as perpetual newcomers. They move to a different city every 90 days, every 3 months, and they tell the story of living in that place as a brand new person. Talk about committing and creating a niche. These guys own it completely, doing things very, very differently. This is Candace Rose Reardon at the bottom. Candace Rose Reardon, excuse me. Candace is a sketch artist, traveling around the world painting awesome watercolor sketch artist post paintings and selling those on Etsy. If you go to her blog and you read up on it, you probably would know she's a sketch artist, but you may not know she sells stuff on Etsy because every blog post isn't, come buy my latest piece. Her blog posts are about the travels and the experiences she has along the road. It's not all about commerce. Why? Because it's not all about commerce. There's more things to do. She does a really great job of it. Then there's this guy, Nathan Sada, who's here. I don't know if he's in the room or not. Nathan, are you here? Nathan? Yeah, there he is over in the corner. Right over there. We're going to talk about these two people. And these three people. Oh, man, all three are in a little cluster area right there. Awesome. So Nathan is personal trainer, fit guy. And he's rolled that into his blog. His blogs, when he blogs about them, are about staying fit and healthy on the road. Perfect. He's managed to figure out a way to blend travel with blogging and his own profession. That's a great niche. What they all have in common? They're all doing what they're good at. They're all doing completely what they're good at, and that's the takeaway, is they know what they're good at. Do you know what you're good at? You can copy their tactics, but will they work for you? No, probably not, to be really honest with you. They likely will not work for you, because you can never recreate the exact same set of circumstances that led to someone else's success. You just can't do it. That's not a very good way. Sometimes you don't have the same skills that person does. Quite often that's the case. But more often than not, there is absolutely no reason that you can recreate that caused that person's success. I'm not saying these people that I'm talking about here got lucky. I'm just saying that it is not always the way you think about it. By way of example, no rational person should take writing and publishing advice from best-selling author E.L. James. Seriously, there's plenty of bad erotica out there. She just got lucky. No rational person takes financial planning advice from millionaire Mike Miles, because he made his million by winning the lottery. Awesome, but I'm pretty sure buy a lottery ticket is not the wisest advice. And no rational person takes the story of Mackenzie here, who jumped out of an airplane and her parachute did not open and she survived. That's awesome, but that doesn't mean you should follow her for healthy living tips. And I don't care who you're listening to, ignore any advice you hear about viral video. It follows no rhyme or reason. Congratulations on your success, Sai. There is no secret magic formula to success. It doesn't happen. If there was, we would all follow it. But there isn't. We simply don't. So, yeah, there's plenty of talk about how many times a day you should tweet, or what the optimal time to post on Facebook is. Great, but that's not a success guarantee. You're not even guaranteed success if you start taking awesome pictures. That's a great idea, don't get me wrong. If you can take awesome pictures, take awesome ones, much better than crappy ones. But that's not a guarantee of success. And you probably won't become an overnight star if, after listening to the talk on podcasting tomorrow, you decide to go out and launch your own podcast, or jump on Periscope 6 times a day like some people in the room. None of this is guaranteed. That's the reality. You have to figure out what it is that you are doing to make yourself really, really successful. Whether it's internally or externally, it doesn't matter. Because once you know what it is that you are good at, it's easy to figure out how you can incorporate that into your own personal travel brand. You may have this question. The hell is my travel brand? I didn't know what mine was when we started traveling 7 years ago. I didn't even know I was a travel blogger. A guy who had a blog and was going to travel somewhere. So if you have this question right now, good news is we're going to help answer that right now. Because in this next part, I'm going to teach you one thing, and one thing only. This is not a reflection of me. This is how to figure out what you are good at. And then I'm going to show you how to incorporate that into your own digital medium, because that is how you start building a successful travel brand. Okay. So conventional wisdom says to become a successful travel blogger, you only need to do two things. Number one, first, pick your medium. Awesome. You could be a travel blogger, there's also travel podcasting, YouTube, Periscope, TV, editor, writer, journalist, whatever. This is almost 2016 now. New mediums are developed almost every day. There's always something new that's out there. There's lots of new platforms and medium. There's a difference between platform and medium. Right? Mediums come up all the time. You heard a lot of conversation today about video. Video is a medium, it's a platform. And it's both a platform and a medium, actually. There are plenty of platforms that do that one. Which one do you want to focus on? By the way, so think about this. When I talk about travel blogging, and when you hear travel blogging the rest of the time, that doesn't mean typey, typey, typey. Think beyond WordPress and Squarespace. There is more to blogging than that. All the things I just drew up here, assume all the travel blogging is shorthand for all of them. But you do really want to focus on one. It's okay to do 2, 3, or 7, but the more folks you have, the better, especially if you're trying to either start out or recreate your own brand. It's a great idea. So one, pick your medium. 2, very simple. Next thing, pick your niche. What are you going to focus on? Luxury, go to the other side and go cheap. You want to focus on hacks, tech gadgets, clothing, airlines, cruising, adventure, 55 plus, house sitting. Whatever. There's an unlimited number of niche topics that are out there. Which one is right for you? So the solution is simple. Pick a medium, pick a niche, and you're done. Drops the mic. I posit to you that, like most people, you are ill-equipped to make those decisions blindly. Because if you do so, you'll wind up chasing a trend that's getting a lot of attention right now. And unfortunately, that trend may not fit with your very specific skill sets. So just blindly picking is not a good idea. Luckily, there's a much better way. And that better way is of beginning to look inwards, not to get all zen and stuff on you, but looking inwards. Now, we're going to do this, for at least for some of you, because holy crap, a lot of you showed up. And I didn't plan this very well. So what we're going to do, if you'll notice on the seats in front of you, there are some stacks of post-it notes. Those of you who wish to play along, and I hope that at least many of you play along. So right now there's post-it notes. You see them? If you're going to play, grab some post-it notes. If you're not going to play, A, you're a party pooper, and then B, please pass it along to somebody else. So we have people who are with me and really want to do this, because I love you more than the rest of the people in the room right now. Are we good? Okay. I'll let you just show that. I'm going to take a drink of water. You will also need something to write with. We're not making square paper airplanes. All right. We have post-it notes in hand. Outstanding. Here we go. And yeah, I'm going to make you guys work with this thing. So in a moment, I'm going to ask the question. Actually, I'm going to ask the same question a lot of different ways. And your job is to write down answers, plural, to that question. This question has lots of answers, one answer per post-it note. You need a pile of post-it notes to make this actually work. I know. Did you guys all just put one? You guys all just share one? I am the worst instructor ever. I'm a terrible, terrible human being. I will let you reapply those together. If anybody's left with like a big one, you can do that. You could do this on a notepad. It's a lot harder to do, so I guess we'll just see what happens here. Man, like I said, very ill-prepared. Well prepared for this, kind of forgot that, you know, post-it notes don't just come on shares, as I assume that might happen like that. All right, so we'll see how this thing works out. Good luck to all of you. Yeah, just ripping the half was a good idea, because a lot would be good. That number is a great number of post-it notes as we go through this one, which is going to be a real big challenge to do. All right, let's just kind of, if we can run through that one. You could do it on a notepad, as I said, but for the second part of the exercise, it's not all that easy. I have no idea how you do it with a laptop. I guess you could try, but as you'll see, it's going to fail miserably. And the same thing for a tablet. Try, but post-it notes are where this works in the boardroom setting. And typically I would say don't write all your answers down on one post-it note, but since you only have one post-it note. The funny joke I wrote here was these trees have already sacrificed their lives for this, so we'll go ahead and burn more paper. But... All right, here we go. All right, so ideally your answers are very short, one, two words. Don't write out three, four, five. You won't have time to do that. You won't have a lot of things. We need lots of single, simple little answers as we go through this one. One thing, move to the next one. One thing, move to the next one. Okay. And also, here's the thing. If you are planning on participating, I promise not to call on you. I will not make anyone read their cards out, so you don't have to worry about embarrassing moments. I'm the king of doing that, but I promise I will not. I will not make anyone read anything out loud. So be honest with yourself as much as you possibly can as we answer this one question. Are you ready? What are you good at? One answer. Ideally, people don't mistake, but one answer. What are the things that you personally are good at? Not what you want to be good at, but literally what you're good at. Think about your job. If you have a real job, like many of us do or did, what do you do in your job that you're good at? It need not be related to travel. What are you good at? When you were in high school, what subjects did you excel in? Anything. We need a long list of things. Your idea here is we're not done. We need more things, so keep going. I will keep repeating this ad nauseum, so keep going. You need lots of things. What are you good at? What are the people around you, your friends, your family, your coworkers, your fellow travel companions, what do they keep telling you you're good at that you continue to ignore? That's always a good barometer. What do your friends around you say you personally are good. And again, it need have nothing to do with travel. We're looking for your own innate skills, the things that you know you're really good at, or that people tell you you are really good at. That's what we're looking for, things that you are good at. There's another way to think about this, and that is, what comes naturally to you? What takes absolutely no effort on your part because it's so stinking easy? Like this for me, standing up and talking to you guys and screwing up post-it notes, very easy for me to do this. This is a natural thing for me to talk in front of people. Doing my taxes, I can do it. I'm not very good at it, and I hate it. It's not a natural thing for me. So what can you kick out with the greatest of ease? Because it's just a part of who you are. What's your DNA set look like? Super easy, always has been easy for you. List some things down that you're good at because they're just so easy for you. Keep writing down some things. Easy is always better. And think about this from a communications medium as well. What communications are good at you? Public speaking. Yeah, okay, easy. For me, maybe not for you, so don't write it down if it's not good for you. Can you write out 500 to 1,000 words in less than half an hour? That's your typey. Maybe not. Maybe you're a long form person. Maybe you want to write down things. Maybe you are the kind of person who constantly fills up that damn WeChat session that I'm in right now with another 800 of you that keeps my phone battery dying. What are the social media tools that you use? Are you excellent on Twitter? Okay, write it down. Communication tools that you yourselves are good at, whatever they happen to be. Maybe you've got a knack for the camera. Taking photos, telling stories, we heard about that earlier. Maybe you're much better behind the camera, capturing those stories and not being a person out in front of it. That's okay. List that down as well. What communication skills are you good at? About 30 more seconds. Thinking about what you're good at, your individual skills that you are good at. What is it that comes easy and natural to you? And again, I don't care about travel blogging at this point in time, just the skills you have. If you're good at braiding hair, write it down. We need a lot of things you're good at. And of course, we need something about communication tools that you're good at. But according to the slide, time's up. Pencils down. I don't care, you can keep writing. In fact, I encourage you to keep writing as we go through this, as I go through some examples of what's happening. So, congratulations. Wasn't that fun?
No, you know that wasn't fun at all.
I get it. So, in about 6 minutes, you guys just did what, individually, I might add, what I normally take a day, day and a half to walk teams of 3 to 5 people through for 2 to 4 hours at a time. So, A, we don't have that kind of time. And B, you got some of you are a couple bloggers, but there's not a lot of teams in here, so you had to do it individually, so congratulations. That's awesome. So now we're gonna take that pile. I see some people actually broke some things up here. So do me a favor real quickly, and either stack up what you have, but I want you to count. More importantly than anything, I want you to count. So everybody right now, take a few seconds and count the number of answers that you have. Had I had enough post-it notes, this would have been awesome, but I'm curious what the number is now. Usually, what we're looking for is a number greater than 10 for everybody, but I have a funny feeling where you are not going to exceed the number. So add them up. Hands up, pretty please, with sugar line, if you have more than 10 things written down that you're good at. Yes. Because this would have been over quickly had you not. Awesome. Thank you. Anybody have more than 20? Okay. Typically, around 35 or so is a really good number. How biggest number? Lower than 20. 18? One? I got 18. I have a 19. A 19. No, you have 20 on the dot. You win. I don't know what you win. I was going to give you some more post-it notes, but clearly I'm out of post-it notes. So congratulations. Okay, so now you've got either a stack or a list of numbers of things that you're good at, which probably isn't all that helpful. Now maybe you had an epiphany as I was talking there and you wrote something down and said, holy criminy, why have I not been blogging about this? Awesome, that's great, but we're not through. Clearly, so that's in the post-it notes, right? The idea, the real magic comes in this next step, because we're gonna do what we humans are really good at, better than any other animal on the planet, and that is organization, looking for patterns, and grouping. That's what kept us alive in the savannah 70,000 years ago, and you're gonna use it to figure out what you are good, what your skills are for blogging. And here's how you're gonna do it. So, in an ideal world, you would all draw a grid pattern. Don't do this right now. I will just show this to you. For now, make four stacks or circle one thing, star another, underlined, and I don't know, bold, again, I don't know. We're gonna denote the things that you have. We're gonna separate those into four different piles or groups or whatever. All right? Need some labels on these grids. So the first one is income. Oh, I should back up and tell you what the hell it is that we're doing. So there are lots of ways that you can organize this stuff. We're gonna use what's known as the portfolio method. The portfolio method is very powerful for individuals, that's all of you, and brands that are just starting out or trying to refocus. Okay, there's lots of things you can do. But for individual travel bloggers, this portfolio method works really, really well. So that's what we're gonna teach you today. There's lots of ways you can do it. I'm teaching you one of those. Okay, so the first bucket or pile or things with circles around them is gonna be income. So looking at your list, go through the numbers, or not the numbers, go through the individual items and circle or stack up the things that you can count on for income. Not you think you can count on this, but I mean with the same certainty that a wage slave goes into the job and punches a clock every day, that kind of certainty. Maybe you're not doing it right now, but if you had to, you could go get a job doing this. If you wrote down taxes, that is a certainty, you know you can get paid for that, right? That's what your income looks like. By the way, it may not have anything to do with travel blogging, that's okay, I will bring it all home in a moment, I promise. So income is the first one. The second thing, and let's do these with stars, if you're doing a list. Next pile is happiness. Of the things in front of you that you said you were good at, what makes you happy? Oh, and by the way, it's okay to have a star and a circle. You can have it multiple places for now. What just makes you happy? There's no income associated with it, and that's perfectly fine, but it brings you joy. Think about that. And as I mentioned earlier, it's okay to write additional things down now that I'm explaining this in a little more detail. This is not a blind taste test here. So we got income, we got happiness. But as a subset of happiness, so let's use this with an underline for those of you that have a list. Personal growth. So these are things that probably make you happy, but more importantly, they make you a better person. And they make you feel like you're a better person. They cause you personally to grow. Yoga, volunteering at a homeless shelter, whatever. These are the sorts of things that are personal growth factors for you. They probably make you happy, but again, they cause you to grow as an individual. And the last bucket, let's see, we had, what do we use? We circled, we starred, we underlined, right? So do something else. Happy faces? I don't know. The last one is called upside. If you can't see this, that's what the bottom one says. It's upside. And upside lives underneath income because the potential for income, lots of income, is there. But the probability is low. So if you wrote down writing a novel and you're not already a published author, it goes under upside. Because the probability of you making a pile of money on your next book, not very high. Take it from a guy who's published. Really not very high. So we got income, things you know you can count on. We've got happiness, things that just simply make you happy. Personal growth, things that make you happy and make you a better person. And upside, that you can't count on the income, but man, wouldn't life be sweet if that ship came in. Let me give you an example, because I ran through this with a volunteer before the session began, and this unnamed volunteer went through the exact same process you did, and I'm not kidding. Went through the whole thing. The only difference was this person actually had a lot of post-it notes as opposed to one. Here's how hers came out. This person's came out. I don't want to give the person away. It's totally not my wife. Under income, she has writing curriculum, teaching process, auditing, and writing down tasks. These are skills she has that she is good at, that she knows either she currently is or she currently could be employing to get income easy. It's an almost guarantee that she could go employ these skills to create income. Your list will be different, but I'm giving you one person's example. Under happiness, she's got talking to people as a communication medium, right? Party planning and making people feel at ease. These don't fit in the money aspect. No one's paying her. She's never had a job as a party planner. She just likes doing that. No one's paid her to feel at ease, except for me, perhaps. So that was not a double entendre, by the way. I didn't realize that could be construed in an appropriate way. My apologies. Those things fit underneath happiness. Now, personal growth, she only has one thing. Sharing my experiences. So one, you need a lot of things in there, but actually that's pretty big. Because if you'll notice, sharing my experiences makes her happy, but it also makes her grow as a person. I didn't prompt this, she did this on her own. Just simply sharing her experiences makes her grow as a person. That's pretty important. And then on the upside, the things that are potentially lucrative, she's got photography, images she can see and she can share, and also the sounds of various places. And that's because if she happens to get picked up by the travel magazine, maybe there's a paycheck at the end of the day, maybe. Chances of that happening, slim, because there's a lot of people out there, but if it happens, it can. Or I also know that she happens to have a podcast, and if that gets picked up by syndication somewhere, maybe there's a chance to make a lot of money, but if somebody who's been in it for 10 years, there's not a lot of money. Big upside, okay? So here's what this tells us about this person. As I step back and analyze this, here's what I look at. The bloggy things that you would understand as blogging, podcasting, writing, editing, video, blah, 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 all of that fits under her upside and personal growth. None of it fits in the income side. And that's okay. Because for this person, the pleasure points of personal growth and the potential of making money eventually are way more important in the income side, which means she's free from a couple of things. She doesn't have to worry about thinking much about affiliate marketing and how to get one more person to follow her on Twitter, because that eventually leads to an SEO plan that blah. That's not why this person is blogging. So that means she should not feel compelled to post something about how to buy a SIM card in Thailand. I guess that's part of her experience, but nothing else for there. Or joining a collaborative blog post to just complain about TBEX. That's not what she has to do. None of that matters for this person. Yours are going to look terribly different than this. But this lets her focus in on her own experiences. It's really hard. I'll just know that's two cute dogs in one presentation. Two cute dogs. As all of you probably know, it is very difficult to have the "so what's your travel blog about" conversation with people. It's really, really hard to do. But if you focus on this portfolio approach and recognize that there are other things you might do to make income, like in her case, she can take a job teaching abroad and continue to be a travel blogger. She can take part-time work developing curriculum and still be a travel blogger, but focusing on the things that make her really, really happy, because it's the things she is strongest in. So that's the trick. Focus on the portfolio approach, and you will have a much easier time telling people what it is that you blog about. So I've just given you a pile of stuff and jammed this down your throat. And again, you guys did in minutes what it takes groups of five or six people days to get through. And so there must be more to this, and yes, there are going to be more. I'm going to give teaching, but there's five more things I'm leaving you with. But before I do that, I saw many of you taking pictures. This is a picture to take, because this presentation in another 21 minutes will go live. Everything I just talked about, exactly, with very detailed notes, not just pictures, because I'm an awesome person. Go to my website, shivo.wtf, and then it's TBEX-Asia-15. Shivo, that's Sheila, and I'm Evo, .wtf, which is exactly what you think it is. TBEX-Asia-15. It will be live soon. If you get a 404, if you go right now, because I scheduled to go as soon as this session is over so that you guys get it before anybody else. So you're welcome. In theory, I'm taking video. If it comes out, I'll put it here. Same exact URL dash video, because I'll shove it up on YouTube so you can watch that too. I have no idea if it'll be of any quality. You've seen it. But feel free to share this around. So let's get back to the takeaways. Things I want to give to you. So number one, me. I just forced you to do an exercise. Thanks for playing, those of you that did, especially in the craziness of not having enough post-it notes. Hey, what are you gonna do? But here's what I want you to do. Take that list, take that pile of shredded paper that you have with you back to your room, and start thinking about this throughout the rest of this conference. Talk amongst your friends. Figure out other things that you are good at. Start writing them down. Write down yourself a list, and when you get home and you can buy your own damn post-it notes, fill all those out and stick them on a wall in your office or in the top of your suitcase, whatever. Put those things in those quadrants. Start adding more stuff to it. And then for the entire month of November, because I'm traveling until then, but for the entire month of November, I'm giving everybody in this room free access to me. So you're welcome to tweet to me, to email me, to don't call me because I won't answer my phone. But whatever, we can do Skype messages. I'm giving you unmetered access to me. That's different than unlimited. Unmetered basically means when I can get to it, I will. And they give you all month long for free. No catch, no coupon codes to enter into. No. Don't worry about any of that kind of stuff. I really honestly want to help you guys. So if you're serious about taking the portfolio method and applying it as either a way to start blogging if you're brand new or a way to change your behavior, I would love to help you do it. And I know I shoved a lot of info, so hopefully this will help out. Drop the grid, let's go back and talk about it, and I can help you figure out where your areas of strength actually are. I can do that, okay? That was number one promise to you. Number two, I want you to be unique, not stupid. There are some things you should do just because they should be done. We call that, it's not following a trend or following the crowd, it's fishing where the fish are. And so there are things you need to do that are the right way. Like, for example, should you be involved in social media? Of course you should, but please, for the love of all that is holy, if you're gonna be involved in social media, fill your profiles out completely. No blue heads, link to your website. Come on, it's social for a reason. Speaking of your website, if the only way people can reach you is through a contact form, what are you doing? Put your email out there, please. Make it easy for people to contact you. So there's some very basic things you ought to be doing. Trend following, that's fine, but it's really fishing where the fish are. Do the right things. Remember that more people read other people's blog. People spend more time on other people's blog than your blog. So you can't be all that crazy and different. Number three, you are more than your blog and your brand. Hopefully, this exercise gets you narrowly focused. One medium is awesome. One type of niche is awesome. But you, as a human, are way more than that. So step outside of that. Don't feel completely constrained by those walls. It's okay to go off message. You are not a brand, you are a human being. You can do that. It is okay to do that. Just remember what your core is and try and circle back to it. And if you don't like that core after 3 days, 3 months, 3 years, change it. You're in charge, not some cheese-giving laboratory person. Fourth thing, going through this process will make you, at some point, terribly frustrated at the travel blogging industry. Really frustrated. Resist the temptation to air those frustrations with the world. Talk to your therapist. Call your mom. I'm the travel blogger, and I don't really care. But don't engage in what I call disgruntled skywriting. And I call it that because it's the one medium that you never see. Can you imagine somebody crawling in their airplane, going up and writing up this stuff they are about travel, about the skywriting? Would never happen. It would do it on blogs and social media all the time. I'm leaving Facebook. Don't do that. Fifth, to bring it all home, there is no one right way. What I have just talked to you about is a right way. There are lots of wrong ways, but there are lots of right ways. So you can do whatever you want to do. It's still a really good idea, though, to figure out what your brand is, working within it, and knowing your limitations, and having a whole lot of fun and experimenting along the way. Thanks again for attending. Enjoy TBEX, guys. I'm done. I have some time left. I have no idea what time it is right now. I'm looking at about 10 minutes, I'm guessing. About 10 minutes left? Yeah. So there's a microphone in the center of the stage. If you have